let's have a look at when depressive disorders develop and what happens with them over time if people do not receive treatment. Major depressive disorder can begin at any age, but onset does increase significantly with puberty. In Western nations, incidence seems to peak in the 20s, although it is not uncommon for onset to be in later life. Persistent depressive disorder tends to have an early and chronic onset. By definition, of course, persistent depressive disorder is a chronic disorder. The course of major depressive disorder, on the other hand, is quite variable. Some people rarely experience remission, defined as a period of 2 or more months with no symptoms or no more than 2 symptoms at a mild level. Others, however, can go for a number of years without experiencing a major depressive episode. Most people, given enough time, will recover without intervention. And this is referred to as spontaneous recovery. For roughly 2 in 5 people with major depressive disorder, spontaneous recovery will occur within 3 months of onset. And for 4 in 5 people, this will happen within 12 months of onset. There are a number of features associated with lower rates of recovery from a major depressive disorder, including symptom severity, personality disorders, and psychotic features. Some of the factors associated with increased risk of experiencing another episode of major depression include the severity of the preceding episode, being younger at onset, and having experienced more prior episodes. Thinking now about persistent depressive disorder, if a person experiencing this illness develops symptoms that meet criteria for a major depressive episode, what will typically happen is that the symptoms will return to a lower level, such that the criteria for persistent depressive disorder, but not major depressive disorder, continue to be met. However, in terms of symptom resolution, this is more likely to spontaneously occur with major depression than it is with persistent depression.